Hello learners, welcome to Environmental Science Senior Secondary course of NIOS. I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of Environmental Science. Welcome you in this program. Dear learners, you are aware that environment has no geographical boundaries. We have exhausted our natural resources so lavishly. Today we are facing environmental degradation. Environmental damage at any one place has an impact on nearby or even distant places. These effects can be seen immediately or slowly in due course of the time. The main reason for this is the rapid increase in population. The growing human needs have resulted in depletion of natural resources, deforestation, loss of biodiversity, water and energy scarcity, increasing exploitation of mineral resources, etc. This has further led to degradation of the environment. Some issues such as land and forest management, water scarcity, energy, fast depletion of resources and many other issues related to demographic factors that influence the changes in human population pattern of human growth will be discussed during this program. This is lesson 13, National Environmental Issues of Module 4. So, the objective of this program is explain the land and forest cover of India, discuss the necessity of studying population growth, analyze the demographic factor that influence the population growth, trace the patterns of human population growth, explain the impact of increasing human population on the environment, correlate urbanization and environmental issues. First section of the lesson is to understand the land and forest cover of India. Map related to land and forest cover in India is showing in next slide. Before we talk about the various environmental issues of concern today, let me once again re-emphasize how large and diverse our country India is. Look at the figure. Do you know that India is one of the 12 mega biodiverse region of the world? India's land area includes region of some of the world's highest rainfall to very dry desert coastline to alpine region, river deltas to tropical island. Map of the India, the physical features of India in next slide. This is a figure of forest green cover. India has about 7,08,273 square kilometer of forest, which is 21.53% of the geographic area of the country, according to India State of Forest Report 2017. There is enough evidence to show that dense forests are covered in India. The variety and distribution of forest vegetation is large. Indian forest type includes tropical evergreen, tropical deciduous, temperate, coniferous forest, swamp, mangrove, etc. The pie chart shows in next slide indicates the percentage of forest cover in India. This is all about different types of forest in India, that is very dense forest, moderate dense forest, open forest, scrub, non-forest. Over the years, as man progressed, the forest began gradually depleting. The changing forest composition and cover can be closely linked to the growth and change of civilization. Major cultural changes have developed new technologies to meet our basic needs and increasing wants. This has no doubt led to an increase in the food supply through better agriculture implements and facilities. The excess food supplies are transported to the region of shortage. The excess food is further prevented from getting spoiled by storing it in proper and safe warehouse and granaries in cold storage. Look at the figure. These are tropical rainforest and temperate rainforest. Another figure is mixed deciduous forest, alpine tundra vegetation, dry broadleaf forest, different types of forest as mentioned in the previous figure. Look at the figure, there is a variety of flora and fauna found in India. Next section is population growth. First we will talk about what is population, what are the factors which are responsible for the increase in human population. Well, there are many, but the important one are birth rate, death rate, migration, etc. Rate at which the births occur in a population, while death rate is the rate at which death rate occur in the population. Growth rate is the number of births minus number of deaths per unit time divided by the total number of individuals in the population. Show the definition of population in this slide. Improved medical technology has led to better health and longer life span by reducing the mortality rate through proper sanitation, medication and immunization, etc. However, the negative impact of these has been on our environment. The growing population and man's dependence on the forest have been mainly responsible for this. Population growth is across of concern, not only for the national leaders, but all for us. Human population has been growing exponentially for centuries. Exponentially means that the population is increasing in number or size at a constantly growing rate. Now come to the biodiversity and population. Biodiversity continues to deteriorate despite our efforts towards its conservation, especially in areas of the world high human population density and growth. Population is considered as an indirect driver of biodiversity loss. Conversion of habitat, overexploitation of resources, pollution, and climate change are direct drivers of biodiversity loss. Population growth, human activity interact with these direct drivers and create pressure on biodiversity and ecosystem. There are many questions come to our mind related to population. Some of them are, how and why population has changed over time? Do we end up resources on this planet to provide food for all? And what impacts do we have on each other? Show this figure, why study population about? Answer is, to ensure sustainable future for humanity and the environment, to know the growth and infrastructure of a country, social and environmental issues are centered around population growth, to know how organisms interact with each other and with the environment, to make better prediction about then factors that may cause the change in population growth and population size. Look at the figure. We will start from Stone Age. Total population was less than few million. When agriculture began, first major raise in population, rapid use in population when industrial revolution started. Now you can see the present situation of population growth. Next slide shows demography and its characteristics such as migration, population size, age structure, natality, mortality, population growth, growth rates and standards of living. First, growth rate, rate of change in population size over time. It depends on the population size, birth rate and death rate. Birth rate or natality, number of live births per thousands of population per year. If total number of population is n, number of birth per unit time is population, in population is n or is b, the natality or birth rate is b is equal to b upon n. Next is death rate, number of deaths per thousand of population per year. If total number of individual in a population is n, number of death per unit time in population n is d. So death rate is small d is equal to b upon n. Growth rate means difference between the total births and total deaths per unit time divided by total number of individuals in a given population. Total number of birth per unit time b, total number of death per unit time d, total number of individuals in a population capital N. Then if b minus d is equal to g, then growth rate is b minus d upon n or g upon n. Now come to the migration and immigration. Movement of individual of a population from one place to another, that is migration. Immigration, to leave one country and settle in either temporary or permanently. Next is internal immigration, movement of an individual from one region of a country into another region of the same country. Human population have been growing exponentially for centuries. Exponentially means that the population is increasing in number or size at a constantly growing rate. World population has almost doubled in 50 years from almost 2.5 billion in 1950 to approximately 6.1 billion in 2000. It may further increase by 2080 to 8 billion in human population. When the population approaches the full carrying capacity, the growth rate decreases and the growth changes from J-shaped curve to S-shaped curve. Look at the figure. This is human population growth J-curve. When bacteria divided every 30 minutes, their number increases exponentially. This number of bacteria in thousand sets of figure assume a zero death rate. But even if a certain percentage of each generation of bacteria died, exponential growth would still occur. It would only take a bit longer to reach the higher number. When data is graphed, the curve of exponential is J-shaped. This is sigmoid growth curve. This pattern of growth in which a new environment, the population density of an organism increases slowly, initially in a positive acceleration phase, then increases rapidly, approaching an exponential growth rate as J-shaped but decline in a negative. This figure shows demography figures of India. It includes population density, growth rate, birth rate, death rate, life expectancy, male and female, fertility rate and Indian mortality rate. Data related to demography of India is shown in slide. I have already told about you. Now come to the demography means. Demography of any place provides a basis for predicting future trends and making decisions for the formulation, implementation and evaluation of plans, policies and programs for health, social service and planning, etc. That is education, health, housing, transportation, employment, recreation and other social services. We can see other services as next section of this lesson is structure of population. Structure of a population is determined by population density, dispersion, age, risk structure and sex ratio. First we will take population density means number of individuals of a species inhabiting a unit area, dispersion of its individual members relative to one another in a given area as shown in figure. This is clamped, regular and random. This figure also shows the details of population dispersion patterns. Age structure, proportion of individual in each age group, sex ratio, number of males and females in a population. Age structure gives us information about current and future status of age profile, possible effects on environment, media, social, housing, health needs, job needs, current and future educational needs, status of elderly people needing social support now and in future, economic status of society. Sex ratio figures are shown in the figure in this slide. Estimated value in 2009 is 1 to 14 years 31.2%, 15 to 64 years 63.6%, 65 years and above 5.3%. This sources are taken from demography of India, human population, urbanization and environment. If there is a sharp rise in population in rural areas, then each family will have more hands to work in the fields. Then why do they migrate to the urban areas? Why do rural Indian migrate to cities in such large numbers? Push and pull factors have been discussed in lesson 8 of this course in detail. Look at the figure. There are some few push factors and pull factors. Now come to the consequences of population growth. It can be inability to grow enough food leading to hunger and famine, overcultivation, soil erosion, depletion of fertility, loss of biodiversity, depletion of natural resources, conflict over obtaining new sources, depletion of water resources, harm to wildlife, social, economic and security crisis and threats, cutting down of trees, that is environmental degradation and land abuse and problems due to rapid rate of urbanization is shown in the figure, that is environmental degradation, pressure on city infrastructure, increase in human insecurity, waste management, etc. as shown in the figure. Environmental degradation can be water pollution, air, soil, radiation, noise pollution, etc. Road congestion, transportation, traffic problem, education, health care are the problems due to pressure or city infrastructure. Waterlogging, shortage of resources, deteriorating law and orders, situation, increased air and waterborne diseases and sanitary and hygiene and waste disposal problems are seen in urbanization. Now come to the urbanization and limited energy resources. Supply to energy is far less than its demand over consumption. Increase in infrastructure like vehicles and electronic goods and development of industries cause energy crisis. In order to provide more infrastructure using excessive non-renewable sources of energy causes energy crisis. Mismanagement of energy resources. Now come to the scarcity of water. Scarcity of water is man-made due to rapid population growth and rising migration from villages to cities in search of better life as shown in the figure. Now there are several other factors. Increasing water scarcity due to uncontrolled pollution, change in living standard, increase in water demand, poor water management practices, lowering of water table, climate change, careless attitude. We have to save water for our future generation. It means save water to secure the future. It can be done as fix leaky pipes, toilets immediately, turn off water when brushing teeth or shaving, use mulches on soil surface, take bath with water from a bucket instead of taking shower bath. Adjust sprinkles to water plant. Fill the bathtub halfway or less. Broom to clean outdoor areas. Water that plants in morning. Pollution causes various ill effects on human health as shown in figure. This figure shows health effects of population on pollution. Some population growth and urbanization has led to water crisis in cities as already discussed. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learned. In India exhibit a great diversity of relief and physical features. Its people, land, forest, oceans constitute abundant natural source. Human population study both as consumer as well as producer help us to provide data for economic planning, conservation of nature, promotion of cultural, regional and linguistic harmony. Study of population is called demography. Helps to know about size, growth rate, mortality, natality, migration pattern, density, dispersion and age structure of the population. People shift from rural areas to urban cities for better education, prosperity, better health care and overall increased standard of living. But however, urbanization in itself result in large scale environmental damage such as river, floodplains, coastal wetlands and resultant loss of delicate habitat. Deforestation, desertification, loss of biodiversity contribute towards pollution of air, soil, water, leads to scarcity of water and increased energy consumption. We all must try to protect and improve our delicate environment. So save water, save air, save soil and save land for our future generation. So dear learners, this is all about lesson 13, National Environmental Issues. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.